So first step first is to see where do we put our code, where do we put our JavaScript inside of our HTML. So we have here this long and beautiful HTML that has also CSS files, but we don't have any JavaScript inside. Now there are three different places that you could really put your JavaScript. The first one is inside of the head. And now because we're working, as we said, in an HTML5 world, we're just going to type the way that you would do it in HTML5. Now, we would work also on older browsers, and this is how it works. You just write script, and you close that script tag as well. So you open and close a script tag, just like you would do in any tag in HTML. Now, in earlier versions of HTML, you had to define what type of script it is. HTML5, we don't need to do that anymore because any script that exists, we're assuming it's JavaScript, JavaScript 1, all browsers are doing JavaScript today, so we don't need to do those differentiations between the different styles. As soon as we put script, we know it's HTML5. There's no need to put anything else but that. And there we go. We have our script tag, and here we could put our JavaScript. All right. And we're inside of our head now. So, by the way, this is our head, which basically means that this is going to be one of the first things that load. It's going to be loaded before the body is loaded. Contrary to that, if we wanted to, we could have created a script inside of our body anywhere we wanted. In our case, we wanted to do it in the header because we wanted to make sure that our script could start even before our page is loaded completely. All right, now if we wanted to put our script in anywhere else, we could have just gone anywhere in our body. Let's say, for example, we want to put it on our right in the end, just before our body ends. And we could put there basically script and close a script tag as well. And there we go. We could have put our script right here. Same deal. And obviously, the only difference are that this is inside of our body, while this is inside of our header, all the way in the top here. All right. So we saw our two main ways of putting JavaScript inside of a page. Now, the third one, which is probably the one that you'd want to do most often and the one that is encouraged by the industry, is to put your JavaScript in external files. Why would you want to put your JavaScript in an external file? It makes it easier for controlling versions. It makes it easier also for sharing between different HTML files. So if you have the same script, why put it in one page? You could share it among the pages. And it also makes you more organized because then you start thinking about how do I create it in a way that I could share between the pages. So let's see how you could do that in how we add a script that is with a source. Script. And we just put here the word source. SRC, and we could close our script tag. That's all we needed, and we could start putting inside of our script away right away our script wherever it is. So in our scenario, we don't have one yet, so we could maybe create a new file. So I'll create a new file, and we'll put here a sample right now, and it's gonna look a little bit weird. Alert. Hello, world. All right, so we're gonna save that file. All right, so I'm going to go inside of my JS folder and I'm going to save it inside of my JS folder and I'm going to call this home.js. I'm going to save that file. And now we have our file home.js, which is inside of the JS folder. So all I have to do here is type js/home.js. And if I save my file now and we look again at the code that I put in here, I'm basically calling an alert message box and sending it the copy hello world. So if I refresh my screen now, we'll see that we're getting this alert box. It's saying hello world. And then our application begins only after that. All right. So there we go. We learned quite a lot of stuff. We've covered so far. We've seen what editors we want to use. We've looked at the HTML5 way of putting in JavaScript. And we've seen our first sample of code where we basically created an alert box and send it some information. In our scenario, we double quoted it around and we said hello tech world. So we're going to see more into that and why we did that soon. So for now, let's forget about that external file and we're going to use our HTML comments to comment out that external JavaScript file. So now that JavaScript file is not going to be loaded. And we're going to work inside of our script for a bit.